Hello, I J Vijay Chandra welcomes you to Bits Connect. As part of web design, today I am going to discuss regarding JavaScript operators. In JavaScript, the role of operators we are going to discuss. The major operators here in JavaScript are arithmetic operators, arithmetic operators. The arithmetic operators are as similar as the operators which are there in C language, that is addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, modulus. As same as in C language, we have addition, subtraction, multiplication, division and modulus. Whereas you all know that addition is for adding two numbers, subtraction is for subtraction, multiplication is the product, division is you will get the division value, whereas modulus you will get the remainder. And here two more additional operators are there, that is increment and decrement. Increment and decrement also comes under the arithmetic operators in JavaScript. Whereas in C language, we will have addition, subtraction, multiplication, division and modulus. Here the additionally two more operators are added, that are plus plus, that is increment, and minus minus is the decrement. After arithmetic operators, the operators are known as assignment operators. The operators which are there after the arithmetic operators are called as assignment operators. The assignment operators are here equal to symbol plus equal to. That means in combination of the arithmetic operators, we are going to have the assignment operators, that is equal to symbol, plus equal to, then minus equal to, then asterisk equal to, slash equal to, percentage equal to. What is the role of assignment operators? Later we will see in the programming part. The same for the assignment operators, what is the role? As an example program we will do in the demonstration. Whereas in the same way for the arithmetic operators, what is the role of each operator, we will check with the JavaScript program. Next comes to, after the arithmetic operators and assignment operators, the next is the comparison operators. Comparison operators. So after the arithmetic operators, assignment operators, the next is the comparison operators, that is double equal to. This is called as equal to. Okay, then we have three equal to symbols. This is known as is exactly equal to. Is exactly equal to. So here comparison operator equal to symbol is used for to explain it is equal to, and three equal to symbols is used which says that is exactly equal to. Then comes to the not equal to, exclamatory mark and equal to, which means for not equal to. So here the comparison operators which we are seeing here are double equal to, which says that equal to, then triple equal to, which says that is exactly equal to, then not equal to, then comes to greater than, which is greater than, and less than, greater than equal to, greater than equal to, greater than or equal to, then less than or equal to. So the operators in JavaScript are, first is the arithmetic operators. Those are addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, percentage, double plus, that is increment, and minus minus, that is decrement. Then comes to assignment operators, equal to, plus equal to, minus equal to, star equal to, slash equal to, that is asterisk equal to, slash equal to, then modulus equal to, that comparison operator is equal to, is exactly equal to, not equal to, greater than, less than, greater than or equal to, less than or equal to. So these are the different operators. In spite of this, the other operators are logical operators. What are these logical operators? And, or, not. Not is given by an exclamatory mark. Not is given by an exclamatory mark. And is given by double ampersand. Or is given like this. So this is about the logical operators. So briefly to say, the operators here, arithmetical operators, assignment operators, comparison operators and logical operators. And in spite of these operators, there is another operator which is known as the conditional operator, which is the most important operator, conditional operator. Same you will find this conditional operator in C language also, where we are going to check a condition. If A is greater than B, print A, else print B. Instead of that, you will use in C language by using a question mark and colon. By using question mark and colon, the conditional operator will be expressed. That is, conditional operators. Let's discuss the conditional operators, condition, question mark, value 1, colon, value 2. That means if the condition is satisfied, the value 1 will be printed or 1 will be executed, else value 2 will be executed. This is all about the conditional operators. So the Java basic operators are arithmetic operators, assignment operators, comparison operators, logical operators, that are AND or NOT. Then comes to the conditional operators, condition, colon, question mark, value, and the value will be shown here. So after these operators, conditional statements. Next it is the conditional statements. Conditional statements, if is a conditional statement which will check. That means if statement is a conditional statement which will give as if condition. If this condition is true, a block of code will be executed. Okay, if this condition is true, a block of code will be executed. Then in the conditional statement, next one is the if else. If condition opening braces, then else, then second block of statements. So this is about if condition, if else condition. Next is if else if is the other conditional statement where continuous variable checking will be there. If condition opening and closing, else if closing and opening, then else if again opening and closing, else opening and closing. This is about the multiple conditions will be evaluated. This is if else if. So if conditional statements or if statements, if else and if else if. Then after this conditional statement, the next statements used here are the supported to the if else ladder. This is the if else ladder, as same as the C language. To support you to the if else ladder, switch statement is used. Switch statement is used in support with the supported with the if else ladder, as same as the C language. Switch some condition, opening braces, case 1, okay, then execution, break, case 2, like that, lost, default, lost is default, then closing. This is all about the switch, as same as in the C language. Simultaneously we will do the demonstration about the these such programs. Next, the final topic here today's lesson is the loops. Next is the loops. Loops is another concept where a continuous execution of the program will be done until some condition is satisfied. A continuous loop will be executed until a particular condition is satisfied. The loops are as same as the C language, that is while loop, for loop, do while loop. Okay, while loop, for loop, do while loop. While loop is while some condition is, while loop will be like this, while some condition is satisfied, then some part of the, some statements will be executed based on this particular condition. Whereas do while is reverse of it, part of execution will be done. So do something while condition will be executed or evaluated later. So the major difference between while loop and do while loop is, while loop, while some condition is satisfied, then the block of code will be evaluated. In do while loop, first it will evaluate the block of code, then the condition will be checked. In the same way, for loop, as same as in C language, the for loop, for variable declaration, condition, increment or decrement. Okay, variable declaration, condition, increment or decrement, as same as in the C language. So, by this, we discussed regarding what are the different operators which are used in the JavaScript. What do you mean by conditional statement? What is the looping structures? And what is if else ladder? And how, in the same way of the C language, what is a switch statement? And after that, we came to the looping structures. In looping, for loop, while loop, and do while loop. By this, I am going to close this particular session. Thank you.